As you can see, we are going to discuss today our first chapter of geography, resources and development. Here you can see two words, resources and development. First we will see what are resources, their classification and these all, and later on their contribution for the development of our country, economy of our country. These are certain types of resources which you can see here. Now, this is the most important question. What is a resource? Everything available in our environment which satisfy our needs. Anything which can satisfy our need, human beings need, is called resource. It should be. Now, here are certain parameters to make a thing a resource. All things cannot become resource. So first one, it should be technologically accessible. Second one, culturally acceptable. And third one, economically feasible. Now what do you mean by these three? Technologically accessible means the technology needed to use the resource must be available. If you do not have technology and you want to use certain things as a resource, that's not possible. Economically feasible means we must have enough money to extract it and use it. And third one, culturally acceptable means it must be accepted by the people. It must not disturb or hurt their sentiments, culture, surrounding home, etc. So these are three basic parameters to make a thing a resource. Now next one, as you can see here, it is interdependent relationship between. Whatever we take or we are taking, we get it from nature. And here we have to use technology. Then we have to use institutions. Finally, this particular thing will be defined as a resource. Until and unless we apply technology, we use our institutions, no thing can become a resource. This is our next one, classification of resources. Can be classified into number of categories. First one, natural and human. So in natural, again further subdivided into two, renewable and non-renewable. We will discuss these all in next slide. Renewable into two, continuous flow and biological. Biological again into two, natural vegetation and wildlife. Non-renewable into two, recyclable and non-recyclable. Whom you can recycle, whom you cannot. Then human. Human again into two, structures and institutions, and quantity and quality. Now, on the basis of these four, how resources can be classified? On the basis of origin, on the basis of exhaustibility, on the basis of ownership, on the basis of development. First one, on the basis of origin. On the basis of origin, resources can be classified into two, biotic and abiotic. Easy to understand, living and non-living. Obtained from biosphere and have life, examples flora, fauna, fisheries, livestock, etc. All things which are composed of non-living things are abiotic, examples rocks and metals. Next one, on the basis of exhaustibility. On the basis of exhaustibility, resources can be classified into again two. First one is renewable and second one non-renewable. Renewable resources whom you can renew, non-renewable whom you cannot renew. Renewable nature, how much you want to use, you can, like solar energy, wind energy, and non-renewable resources. These are all available in a limited amount. For example, fossil fuels. They take millions of years in their formation, but these all are in continuous flow. Next one is on the basis of ownership. On the basis of ownership, resources can be classified into four. These are very easy to understand. Here are given bullets. Easily you can understand what is national, community, or international resources mean. Individual resources. The resources which are owned privately by individuals. For example, a farmer owns his own land. So that land is individual resource of that farmer. Next one, community resources. Certain resources which are used by all members of the community, society. We call them community resources. For example, your public parks are there, forest is there, any pond used by people, that is there. Then national resources. Technically, all resources belong to nation. All are our national resources. But then also, till 19.2 km from your coast, that area comes under your country and that is national resource. Whatever is available up to that area will be considered as a national resource. Then, international resources. International resources, there are certain institutions, those who manage, regulate, like UNO is there, they all will look that which resources till what distance from the boundary of country can be kept in this category of international resources. Here is given beyond 200 nautical miles. So beyond 200 nautical miles from your coast in sea, ocean. Whatever is available, that is international resource. Now you can see here individual, national, community owned and international resources. Next one is on the basis of development, we can again divide resources into four categories. Potential, developed, stock, and reserve. Now what do you mean by potential? We generally say that you have lot of potential, you have lot of caliber. It means you have something which you are not using up to maximum. So resources which are found in a region but not have been utilized, it does not mean that we have not touched them. We are using them, but we have not used them up to maximum. Like Rajasthan and Gujarat, these two states, solar and wind energy, there are available in plenty. But how much or whatever amount we are using, that is not sufficient. Next one is developed. Developed resources means resources which we are using. We know their quality. We know about their quantity. We have done survey, everything. Next one is stock. Resources which have potential to satisfy human needs, but there is no technology to use are included amongst them. It means we want to use them, but we are helpless. We are unable to use because of no technology. Last one is reserves. They are subset of stock which can be used with existing technology, but are consumed for the future generations. In our day-to-day life, we say, keep this as a reserve. Keep this as a reserve means keep this for future need. So here we have technological know-how. We can use them, but we have kept them for future requirements.